We're live.
What's your name again?
It's Frank.
Yeah. Hey guys, let me know if we got everybody on.
Okay.
We got Frank though here from Worldwide Corals. We are actually at Worldwide Corals right now in Orlando, Florida. Absolutely amazing place. We just made a dope video. But we figured while we're here, I'll also film a live so you guys can see for yourself. And also, like I said, that dope video is coming out. It's going to be everything in detail. But like I said, we're going to just film a quick little tour of the place for you guys live.
I'm really excited.
Yeah.
Nick, appreciate you coming by doing this video. I'd love to answer some questions.
Yeah, any questions, you guys drop them down. Frank is going to answer them. Okay?
So to the best of my ability.
Yeah, best of his ability. There's a lot to answer.
There's a lot going on here, but we'll definitely show you a little bit of everything. And
how many people?
We have about 130.
130, so all right. Okay, well, let's
Make our way through.
Look at all these tanks, by the way. All these tanks. They don't just sell corals, fish, they sell everything saltwater related. So it's a pretty big place we got here.
Everything you need for your aquarium.
And this is what, the coral farm?
This is the coral farm. It's about 11,000 square feet.
Wow, look at this place. Basically tanks on tanks on tanks. And now the color might look a little weird of all the blue lighting, but wait, hold on.
Stay right there. How does this look? Better?
Yeah, that's so cool.
Does it look a lot better?
Yes.
All right, we got the orange lens on. Hopefully that helps bring out the colors of the coral a lot more, but look at this, right to the right of me. Look at this. How big are these tanks right here, Frank?
They are 750 gallons. There's three of them here, and they're all connected behind our raceways that we basically grow and cultivate all these corals. Each tank is specific. Some of these are mixed reef. The one in the middle is all Acropora, and we'll show you basically each tank and what each of them has. So, you know, you'll get to see a little bit of everything here.
And there's so much going on. We got people packing shipments right now, doing water testing. It's crazy. This place is insane, awesome. Can't wait to show you guys.
There's always something going on every day here. So, you know, when you're running a place like this, you're cutting corals, you're maintaining the tanks, you're constantly cleaning stuff, so there's always something to do here.
Yeah, I love it. Everywhere you look, there's someone doing something. You got one of the workers over there doing something with the coral. What are they doing? What's this station right there?
They're basically cutting corals, so that way we can mount them on a plug and grow them out.
Oh, that's cool. And all these tanks are full of coral.
Every single tank here is full of coral.
Look, we got more in the back here. Absolutely insane. What are the questions looking like?
Which fish is good for our community tank?
Community tank,
we have these school of bangas here. If you want to take a look at these, this is awesome. We put them in when they were tiny, little tiny babies. It's been about maybe 9 months now, and there's a school of them in here.
Wow, those are awesome. I love how they're just like, they're just still.
Yeah, and there's more on the other side too.
Someone said, how many corals do you have?
Honestly, there's no way we can count them.
Millions.
Tons.
There's probably, hundreds
and
thousands.
And this is just
this
half of it.
Someone said, what coral is good for a beginner?
I would really look into zoanthids, LPS, mushrooms, leathers. Leathers are always a good one to have just because they're really hardy, really easy to keep. And they come in a variety of different colors and different shapes. So it's always an easy one to keep is a bunch of leathers in your tank, just for beginners. Once you start to venture off, LPS is something that most people get into after a while. It's just because there's so many diverse types of corals. Just like a lot of these in here, there's tons of LPS and they have so many different colors.
That's
so cool.
It's insane how much there is to coral. Like you could just go on and on and on about it.
Yeah, we could talk to you forever about it, but
we did come out with a video. We actually just made it here literally 10 minutes ago. Everything in detail, up close, GoPro footage underwater, up close to the corals, and that's going to be coming out. Like I said, we're just touring right now. This is like a quarter of the place. They got an upstairs, they got another office, they have a whole outside area with more tanks and fish. That video is going to be probably dropping in this week sometime, so stay tuned for that. Let's keep touring this place.
That's awesome, Dave. Thanks for filling everybody in on that.
I'm excited to edit it. I'm really excited. Well,
there's just, honestly, it's so hard to... Really, I mean, you're here and you see it all, but it's just really hard to see when you're behind the camera.
We got a good question.
What's that?
Yeah. What's your most expensive coral?
Well, this is going to be one of them for sure.
Wow. Right here. Look at that coral right there. So pretty.
I can't really put a price on it, but it's up in the thousands of dollars, of course. Just because
thousands of dollars for that. And I know there's some corals out there that can go for very, very pricey.
And we can show you some more things as we walk along. And if I see something that's really expensive, I'll show it to you. Cool.
Someone said, what's your favorite coral?
My favorite coral. Come check this out.
Ooh. Oh,
there you go. Oh look, they got the little guard dog. By the way, Worldwide Corals has a guard dog for the coral. So if you ever try to come in here, get up.
He's kidding.
I'm kidding.
There's a rainbow chalice here that's got all the different colors.
Oh wow, look how good that looks on the camera.
Yeah, there's...
What the coral? Holy wow. How are we doing? That's awesome.
That's so cool.
And then these are quarantine tanks, huh?
Yeah, these are things that we grow. They've basically gone through quarantine, so they're 100% clean of pests, of any, you know, any nuisance allergies. We keep all of these corals here because they've gone through the process.
The system is so legit here. It's insane.
Someone said, what's your biggest coral?
Biggest coral.
There's a bunch of big corals. It's hard to see because they're behind the rocks.
I don't know if I mentioned this, but Worldwide Corals is one of the biggest coral distributors in the country of the United States. So literally corals everywhere. They have any size you can think of, almost any coral you can kind of think of. They have.
Look, got some little tangs.
We're gonna get to some fish. Right now we're touring the coral, but they do have some really, really cool fish out here.
We do. And we're gonna show everybody Casper in a little bit too.
Casper.
That's one of my favorites, for sure. Can we go over here?
Let's do that.
Look, okay, we got a tank right there.
Oh, look at him. Now, what's the purpose of having the fish in the coral tanks?
Just so nutrients? Every time we put a fish in a tank, there's a purpose for it. So a lot of these tangs that we have in here are for algae. So they do basically algae control. They'll pick and they'll clean the tank. And that's what everybody should have is, you know, some type of fish that'll help clean the tank.
Yep.
And so that's what we do here is we basically put guys like this. He's like a dog. You can pet him.
Literally, like a dog.
Yeah.
And he just maintains the tank.
And he helps clean the tank.
Yeah.
That's awesome. If you guys think we should maybe set up a coral tank and have Worldwide Corals help us set it up, let me know in the comments down below what you guys think. I think it would be pretty cool. Something small to start off, and then we can maybe get into something bigger once we learn a lot more about it. And I think that would be a cool little idea.
They ship over 100 orders a day. And look at that. It's always, like I said, always something going on here.
What else is there, Frank? We just got a small shipment in. So we got some new corals. And then there's a display tank behind you that we'll show you. This is kind of cool, too. Because everybody loves anemones. They all love the clownfish.
Oh, someone just said, do they have anemones? That's funny.
That's funny.
So,
yep, well,
check all these guys out.
Got some clownfish actually in the anemone here. Yeah. Wow, that's cool. This is one of my favorite tanks. Look at how pretty this looks.
So we gotta show you this one. This is a cool tank.
Look at that. The colors, you can't keep your eye on one thing. There's so much going on. Very, very cool.
Wow.
There's just a lot to look at.
Literally tanks everywhere, guys.
Check out this field of hammers over here.
For anyone who's big into corals, it's probably flipping out right now. This is like a dream. This is awesome. Gotta make the trip again.
So cool.
So cool. Any questions? Anybody asking anything to answer? Also, for anybody who donates, we will greatly, greatly appreciate it. So. Thank you for anyone who donated to us. I love it, dude. That is
awesome. Just
is there like a really rare coral here?
This one's really rare that we talked about. That's why it's really expensive. But there are numerous corals like that OG bounce mushroom.
Look at some of these ones, Corey.
That one's pretty cool. I don't know if he's rare, but the colors are beautiful.
Yeah, that thing's amazing.
Got some more over
these
here.
Magic carpets are really cool too. Those mushrooms right there. And those are popular. They're called Rasta zoanthids. It's got the same colors as Rasta. And they've just been around in the hobby for a really long time.
So much to learn about. It's insane. You go over to the fish?
Yeah, let's do that.
Well, like, you got a little pink cow trigger?
Yep.
I didn't know.
You know about it.
I didn't know that they can go with corals, can they?
They can go with SPS. So they won't nip on the corals that we have in here.
Okay.
We actually named this one Trigger Reef, because we have three triggers in here that we really like a lot.
Really?
And usually, like you said, nobody, you know, typically puts triggers in reef tanks, but in this specific tank, we can have them.
That's cool.
Do you have any corals that don't exist in the ocean anymore?
There's probably a few here. There's honestly, when it comes to the ocean, you can't really say that, because it, you know, it could be anywhere. You never know. But there's definitely some rare corals here that you don't really see collected anymore. And I think that's why we're here, is to make sure that we, you know, keep the hobby going, making sure that we have those corals available for the future. And that's why we're growing everything here. Because one day you might not be able to, you know, get certain things, especially things that are wild and being collected. If anything happens, we still can sustain the hobby and we can still grow it.
Yeah, that's true.
And it's all about the environmental aspect. And that's why we do what we do here, is because we feel like there's a responsibility on our end to make sure that we keep things alive and keep it going for the future of the hobby.
Andrew sent you $5.
Thank you, Andrew. Shout out to Andrew for the donation. Any donations we really, really appreciate. Thank you.
That's awesome. Let's go check out some fish.
Yeah, let's go check out some fish. Come on, guys.
So this is our fish system. Most of this stuff, you know, a lot of these fish go in and out since we sell them, so they don't really stay very long. But we always keep a, you know, good amount of fish in stock, and we always have a good amount of variety. We try to support anything that's tank bred, anything that's captive raised. So you'll see a ton of captive raised fish in here.
What's the biggest fish you can put with a coral?
The sky's the limit, depending on how big your tank is at this point.
Depends on how big your tank is.
Yeah, it depends on how big your tank is. And we'll show you the big tank in the back, and that way you can gauge how big some of these fish really are.
I've never seen corals in such a big aquarium. Like, this is my first time seeing them in, like, a whole coral tank dedicated, or a whole 1,000-gallon aquarium dedicated to coral. Insane. I'm gonna show you that.
Let me try to find some cool fish for you guys to check out.
Oh, this starfish is cool. Wow. Look at this.
You probably take...
Or no.
Actually looks better with it.
Yeah, it does.
Yeah. Look at that starfish right there. So pretty. There's a whole bunch of starfish.
Check out these clownfish that we have. They're called orange stormfish, and they're fairly new to the hobby.
Oh, is this like a new species?
Oh, a new type of tank-bred clownfish that they're starting to develop a different trait. And it's got a cool pattern to it.
Can you put coral in a saltwater pond?
If you set it up correctly, you can have a saltwater pond. And it also depends on where you live.
And actually, they have a saltwater pond of coral, so we're going to get to that too.
Yeah. And back here, we'll show you some of the larger fish.
Look at these guys.
Now these are little frags that you guys sell?
Yeah, so these are all the corals that came out of that tank.
Oh, wow.
So we frag them, and then we're just setting them up for the future sale.
This looks insane.
Wow, look, so there's Casper. Guys,
there's Casper.
Probably the one and only white tang.
In the world.
In the world.
Yep.
Literally, 10 years old. White tang, probably not albino, but what's the word for
Lutescence?
It? Yeah.
Doesn't have red eyes, but he's all white. That is beautiful. And then we got this big old
unicorn
tang.
It's my favorite.
Look at the horn on that guy.
But I mean, look at the size of this aquarium compared to me.
Oh, I mean, it's bigger than all of those.
Crazy. In the video that we filmed today, we got top views. We got GoPro footage of in the tank. Absolutely crazy. So that video, like I said, coming out later this week. So stay tuned for that.
Unbelievable.
Got more.
Definitely my favorite tank.
This is like what? The anemone tank?
Just the anemone tank.
Oh my god.
This tank is all about going with the flow. That's what we say.
I can tell. Going with the flow. Looks like Corsair in the wind.
Was that a compliment?
Crazy.
That's awesome.
I think this one might be my favorite tank.
Should we end it off with the coral lagoon?
Let's do it.
Let's do that.
That's
going to
be cool.
I think that's
look at this.
That's what everybody's
going to
be waiting for.
If you want,
it's kind of tan through the bottom here. All these are for sale, by the way. They have so many options. It's insane.
Look at the lighting though, that they have on all these tanks. All built into the top. That's so... I love how clean everything is.
Alright, here it is, guys.
Saltwater coral pond. I've been hearing about this thing forever. Finally, today was the day I came to see it.
Eric, you want to come around here, Kurt?
Yeah.
Guys, look, we've got a remora and a golden puffer in their big show tank over here.
Let's get a close-up on the puffer.
You ever seen a remora in a fish tank? Look at that. We catch these guys all the time, and then look at the golden puffer. That is one of the most yellow ones I've ever seen. It's
so
really good color.
That golden puffer actually has a name. It's one of our mascots.
Really?
Its name is Chiquita. Like the banana.
Hi, Chiquita.
So pretty. We may have to get one of those guys for the pond one day.
Oh, really? Definitely. That's one of my favorites.
So much personality.
So much personality.
What you guys have all been waiting for, the saltwater coral pond. That's so funny that someone actually asked about it, because look, Worldwide Corals has it.
So this tank is 1,200 gallons.
1,200 gallons. How's maintaining it?
We just get in, we hike up our shorts, and we get in and get all dirty. We do water changes every week or two, depending on if it's needed. We clean the sand. And we feed the heck out of this tank.
I bet.
The amount of fish in here, we literally feed it all throughout the day.
What do you feed them?
We actually make our own food here.
Really?
So we have basically a mixture of different types of seafood that we make. We actually sell it too. But it's a concoction of different types of fish and shrimp and some other additives that we concoct together. But the fish do really well and they love it. As you can see, some of these fish are just, they're just big
so
and happy.
Healthy. No, we really actually got to go in the pond. Victor, the owner, let us go in here with the GoPro and go.
I can't even believe they let him
do it. It was insane, guys. I thought going in my pool pond was crazy. No, this pond is like, this is on another level.
That is so cool that he lets you do that. That's what's gonna make it, man. I mean, when you do that video and you edit, it's gonna be so awesome. Dope.
Thumbnail right there.
Best videos for sure. And look, they even have the mangrove in the back.
Check this out. I'm gonna turn off the power head.
Yeah.
And you're gonna be able to see everything from the top.
Oh, wow. Look at, I can't get over the mangrove. How old's that mangrove?
I don't know how many years it's been, but if I had to guess, maybe 7 years old,
yeah.
8 years old.
We're turning off, Frank's actually turning off the pumps right now so we can get a top view. See all the colors on the coral. So amazing.
If you want, you can get me back here.
You can get here. You want me to take the camera?
I got it.
Look at that.
So, I mean, this is probably the best view you're gonna get in the house.
Wow, that's so gorgeous.
Check how big that mushroom is. It's the size of a bowling ball, and it's one single mushroom.
This is crazy. Look at me from over here. Absolutely crazy. There's fish all over the place. It's just crazy.
You have to have one of these in your house one day.
One day.
I mean.
One day. This is literally an ecosystem, a coral ecosystem. Man-made, crazy.
Do you have any dangerous corals?
There are certain types of, like, polythoas, which are a type of zoanthid. If you read about them, they do have some toxin that could be an issue if you had a cut on your finger or if something happened with the slime and it got into your bloodstream. Definitely something to look out for. If we ever sell one to a customer, we have a warning label that explains to you to be careful. So there are a few corals that, you know, could potentially be an issue, but as long as you're careful, you know, you're totally safe.
Which is the most exotic coral in this tank?
Exotic coral. You know what? That deep water Ricordia, that pink one down there. If you show people that, there's not anything else that's like it.
That pink one right there?
Yeah, with the bubbles.
Yeah.
If you look closely, it's insane.
Can you see it, Corey?
Yeah.
Look at this little clinger ass. I want to get a whole bunch of them for the bond. And clean the grouper's gills and stuff, pick all the parents, thanks all. Yeah, Frank, thank you for the tour. Absolutely crazy experience at Worldwide Corals. Huge shout out to Victor, the owner, for making everything happen. Like I said though, guys, we did do a whole video in detail, everything from top to bottom of this place. It's gonna be coming out later this week. Huge shout out to Frank for giving us the tour.
If any of you guys are in Orlando, please stop on by, you gotta come see it.
I promise you, you won't regret it. Absolutely insane place. Make sure you guys give this video a thumbs up. Comment down below if you guys want to continue seeing more live streams and doing little videos like this. Thank you, Frank.
Nick, thank you for coming.
We'll see you guys in the next one.
See ya.
See ya.
Perfect.
Thank you, Frank.